everyone. Welcome to Grace for Today. We're on Thursday already. It's the week is flying in as usual. And this morning I want to talk to you about how if it matters to you, it matters to Jesus. For me, that's something I need to remind myself of. Lots of times I can think, you know, is God really concerned about this? He's only bothered about the important stuff. But actually, the Lord knows everything that's on our hearts, and he just wants us to come with those things because it really does matter to him. Remember, he says to cast our cares onto him because he cares for us. But that's actually not our verse for today. We're going to read another verse. It said, when Mary reached the place where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who had come along with her also weeping, he was deeply moved in spirit and troubled. We'll read that in John 11, verses 32 to 33. Now, all this week we've been looking at the story of Lazarus and Mary and Martha, and yesterday we saw how Martha, despite her grief and confusion, she still held out some faith that Jesus could come and restore her brother in the resurrection on the last day. Yet you see, when Mary comes, her response is different to her sister's. There appears to be no faith here, in fact. You know, she just falls at his feet. She's not running to Jesus, believing that now he's here, you know, things are going to finally turn around. She runs to him, she's defeated, she's distressed, she's helpless. In fact, she just, you know, she's literally hopeless at this stage. But let's look at Jesus' response to Mary. You know, do you notice what he did here? Mary had nothing but disappointment. And Jesus doesn't chastise her for a lack of faith. He doesn't tell her off for not believing in his word. He doesn't lecture her on, you know, where she should have been doing better. You know, did you not listen to me, Mary? He doesn't do anything like that. He's not pointing the finger. You see, Jesus meets Mary where she's at, and he demonstrates just he is full of love and he's full of care for her. You know, he sees her heart is broken because of the loss of her brother. And Jesus sees her in this pain and suffering, and what's he do? He actually weeps with her. He has such compassion on her. He has such love for her that his response is just to meet her where she's at and to weep. He reveals to Mary that what she feels matters. And he acknowledges the sorrow that she's experiencing and that it's real. And we know that he's going to, you know, it's easy for us because we know the story. We know what's going to happen next. We know he's going to speak the word. He's going to reveal his power and glory. And Mary's going to see this incredible transformation, and her mourning is going to turn into dancing. You know, he's going to prove to her the facts that she is facing are not the final word over Lazarus's life. But right at this moment, he meets her in her anguish. He comes down to the level of her grief and heartache, and he leads her away from that despair into the life that he has for her. Isn't that a lovely picture? If we think of that, and if we start to go, well, you know, Lord, if that's what you did towards Mary, that's how you're going to, you know, respond to me today. That's what he's like for us. You know, Jesus isn't distant. He isn't, you know, he doesn't not understand your emotions. He's not emotionless towards you. He comes and he meets you where you're at. Whatever is going on with you, in your hurt, in your pain, in all your confusion, with all the questions that might be going through your head, with the doubts, with fears at times, he wants to come and he wants to bring light into those dark places, the places in your heart where you're feeling scared and alone. Because listen to this today, he is full of love for you. He's moved by what's going on with you right now. You know, he's not distant in any way. Right now, whatever is going on, he's there with you. He's moved by it. And he knows and he understands. And more importantly than all of that, he doesn't judge you. You know, so many of us are afraid of being judged, or we don't like that feeling. And at times we turn away from the Lord thinking that's how he's going to treat us. But we don't need to worry. He doesn't judge us. When we're at our absolute weakest and our lowest point in life, religion will tell us that we failed, that we're not as good as we ought to be, that we shouldn't be struggling with this at this stage in our lives. Like, you know, and we know all those things that go around in our heads, don't we? We hear those lies that things will never change, that we're, you know, we are not as loved as someone else is. But the truth is that when we feel lost and when we feel weak and when we're at the end of ourselves, you know what? That's actually the best place for us to receive from the Lord. So you might feel like the only thing you know to do is fall at Jesus' feet today. Well, see what happened with Mary. That was the best thing for her to do, just to surrender, just to fall at Jesus' feet, Because this is a place of grace. That's where grace can truly flow to you, because you've emptied yourself of everything that you can do, all your effort, all your striving. When there's nothing left for you to try, look at what happened for Mary. You know, one day she's fallen at his feet in despair, and then look, not much later, she's at his feet in adoration, because she recognizes who Jesus truly is, that she is in the presence of the King of all kings. You see, so whenever you throw yourself at Jesus' feet, know that you're not going to remain on the ground looking down at the dirt, because as you humble yourself and trust in his life-giving power, you're going to experience him as your living hope. And what does Jesus love to do? He loves to lift us up. He is going to set your feet upon a rock today. He's going to restore your dreams, and he is going to give you a future, because that's who he is, the King of all kings, our Savior, our Deliverer, and our Redeemer. You see, Jesus just delights in revealing his glory in your life. Isn't that fantastic? Jesus today is setting our feet upon a rock, and he's lifting us out of all the things that burden us, and he's saying, put your eyes back on me, because I have an incredible future for you. So Jesus, I want to thank you for that today. I just thank you that we can receive from you because of what you've done for us. So that's why we do this every morning. We take communion. It's not a ritual. It's our declaration. This is this power when we do this, when we declare the work of Jesus over our lives, that we can receive, we can run to his feet. There's nothing separating us today, because he's paved the way for us. So Jesus, thank you for your body broken on the cross for us, that today we can receive health, healing, wholeness in our bodies, wholeness in our minds, all those things that we worry about, that we're afraid of. Jesus, we just thank you that everything has been defeated at the cross, every curse broken. Thank you, Jesus. And Lord, we celebrate the new life that we can live in today, that we're not looking at our sins, looking at all our failures and all our mess ups, but Jesus, we're looking, knowing that we're righteous because we're clothed in your righteousness. So thank you, Lord. So I hope today that you just remind yourselves that whatever matters to you, whatever's going on in your life, it matters to Jesus. Know that he's with you throughout the day. Know that he's answering your prayers, and know that he is so close to you. In your moments of weakness, he's right there. So be encouraged, have a brilliant day, and we'll be back tomorrow for more Grace for Today.